In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I welcome you all in fifth Sunday after Pentecost. Let's pray. O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful day. It's your grace that we all are alive. Thank you for everything. Now open our hearts, open our ear, that we may praise and worship you with our whole heart. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's we adore God by singing hymn number 13. Hymn number 13. New every morning is the love, our waking uprising prop. Please turn with me reading for Sunday worship book, page number 138. Today's theme is the authority of Christ's messenger is based on their living contact with him. Let all the ends of the world be turned unto the Lord, and let all the families of the nation worship before him. The grace of Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's we pronounce prayer of purity together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whose spirits are gifts, clean the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may love you and worthy magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
One God, now and ever. Amen.
Please be seated for the scripture reading.
Elisha, having been called by Elijah, goes to live with him as his disciple. The Old Testament reading has been taken from 1 Kings chapter 19, verses 19 to 21. I repeat, 1 Kings chapter 19, verses 19 to 21. Elijah departed from there and found Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him, and he was with the 12th. Elijah passed by him and cast his mantle upon him. And he left the oxen and ran after Elijah and said, "Let me kiss my father and mother, and then I will follow you." And he said to him, "Go back again for what I have done to you." And he returned from following him and took the yoke of oxen and slew them and boiled their flesh with the yokes of the oxen and gave it to the people, and they ate. Then he arose and went after Elijah and ministered to him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our rise up for responsibility from Psalm.
Psalm 65, 4 to 8. Your response will be, "Thou art the hope of all the ends of the earth. Thou art the hope of all the ends of the earth. Blessed is the man whom thou choosest and receivest unto thee. He shall dwell in thy courts. May we be filled with the pleasures of thy house, even of thy holy temple." Response:
Thou art the hope of all the ends of the earth.
With terrible deeds hast thou answered us for our deliverance. O God of our salvation, thou that art the hope of all the ends of the earth, and of the isle that are far away, who in thy strength settest past the mountains, and art girded about with power, who stillest the raging of the seas and the noise of their waves and the tumult of the peoples. Response:
Thou art the hope of all the ends of the earth.
They that dwell in the uttermost parts of the earth are afraid at thy wonders. Thou that makest the morning and evening to come forth with shouts of joy. Response: Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Please be seated for second reading of Epistles.
The boldness of Peter and John is explained by their having been with Jesus. Today's second reading has been taken from Acts chapter 4, verse 13 to 22. Acts chapter 4, verse 13 to 22. Now, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated common men, they wondered, and they recognized that they had been with Jesus. But seeing the man that had been healed standing beside them, they had nothing to say in opposition. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred with one another, and saying, "What shall we do with these men? For that a notable sign has been performed through them is manifest to all the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. But in order that it may spread no further among the people, let us warn them to speak no more to anyone in this name. So they called them and charged them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered to them, "Whether it is right in the sight of God to listen to you rather than to God, you must judge. For we cannot but speak of what we have seen and heard." And when they had further threatened them, they let them go, finding no way to punish them because of the people. For all men praised God for what had happened. For the men on whom this sign of healing was performed was more than 40 years old. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Yes, we prepare our heart by singing hymn number 133. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see our God.
Jesus withdrew with his disciples to the sea, and a great multitude from the Galilee followed, also from Judea and Jerusalem, and Idumea, and from beyond the Jordan, and from about Tyre and Sidon. A great multitude, hearing all that he did, came to him. And he told his disciples to have a boat ready for him because of the crowd, lest they should crush him, for he had healed many, so that all who had diseases pressed upon him to touch him. And whenever the unclean spirits beheld him, they fell down before him and cried out, "You are the Son of God." And he strictly ordered them not to make him known. And he went up on the mountain and called to him those whom he desired. And they came to him, and he appointed 12 to be with him and to be sent out to preach
and had authority to cast out demons. Simon, whom he is surnamed Peter, James the son of Zebedee, and John the brother of James, whom he surnamed Barnabas, that is, sons of thunder, Andrew and Philip and Bartholomew, and Matthew and Thomas, and James the son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, and Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise be to God, Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our God, our Rock and Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated.
Today is the fifth Sunday after Pentecost, and the theme for our meditation is the authority of Christ's messengers is based on their living contact with Him. The authority of Christ's messengers is based on their living contact with Him. Jesus Christ called and chose some people to be His messengers or disciples. He called those He wanted. They did not choose Him, but He chose them. He called those whose hearts were right and responsive. He knew the heart, and His call was based on the principle of heart response. He called His 12 disciples to Him and gave them authority to drive out impure spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. He appointed 12 that they might be with Him and that He might send them out to preach and to have authority to drive out demons. He called His disciples for four specific purposes. Number one, the disciples were called to be with Jesus. The disciples were to live in Jesus' presence, ever learning of Him and drawing their spiritual nourishment and strength from Him. Second, the disciples were called to be sent out. They were to be His ambassadors or messengers, His representatives who moved out into the world. They were called for that very purpose, to represent Him among the people of the world. Third, the disciples were called to preach. They were to be the heralds, the messengers of Jesus Christ. He had a message for the world, and they were to proclaim His message to the world. He said to them, "Go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation." Fourth, the disciples were called to receive authority and power, the authority and power to minister and to heal sickness and to cast out demons. In Luke chapter 10:19-20, Jesus says, "I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions, to overcome all the power of the enemy. Nothing will harm you. However, do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." There is power in the name of Jesus, and power of God is given to those to believe in Jesus Christ. Christ is the power of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 24 says, "Christ is the power of God and wisdom of God." Jesus has all authority in heaven and on earth. For by Him all things were created, in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through Him and for Him. It could be no less than the authority of God. for all lesser authorities were those he created. In Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 to 20, Jesus says, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." By saying this, he is urging his disciples to recognize his eternal authority and to teach and baptize by that authority. The authority given to him from eternity is continued with him, undiminished. The Father gave him his authority, and he did not deny that authority. That is why Jesus Christ was full of grace and truth. Jesus is the unique Son of God. He is man, but unlike other men, he is God, having been begotten of the Heavenly Father. So he was in a unique position to teach the world truth. Therefore, in John 8, verses 26 to 28, he says, "I speak to the world those things which I have heard from the Father. As my Father taught me, I speak these things to you." We need to know about our authority in Christ. We are living in the most intense time in human history, the last of the last days. The pressures are mounting, and devil is working overtime on every side. It's a time to use the authority God has given us. God wants us to walk in the greatest anointing and authority that this world has ever seen. Jesus Christ has given us authority over the enemy. That means we need to recognize what comes from Satan. Be conscious of the fact that we have authority over him and use that authority instead of letting him dominate us. Because Satan is already defeated, it is up to us to enforce that defeat by taking authority over him and his works. During his earthly ministry, Jesus told his disciples, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." It is not brute force power, it is delegated power. That word translated power also means authority, and it is given not only to the disciples of Jesus then, but to everyone who believes in Jesus today. In Luke chapter 24, verse 49, he says, "Behold, I sent the promise of my Father upon you, but stay in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high." That's the authority we have in Christ. We are not stopping the forces of darkness, that is sickness, fear, evil, lack, with our own strength. We are stopping them with the delegated authority given to us by God in Christ. We are backed by all the power of God. How amazing is that God Almighty Himself is the power behind our authority. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 says, "Be strong in the Lord and the power of His might." That means we can step out in front of the devil, hold a power hand, and say no, backed by the power of God's might. Christ's power and authority belongs to us. The Bible says that we are the body of Christ. Jesus is the head, we are the body, and his authority is perpetuated through the body. When Jesus rose from the dead, he transferred his authority on earth to his body, the church. God highly exalted Jesus and gave him the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. In God's mind, when Christ was raised, we were raised. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6 says that God raised us from the dead along with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms, because we are united with Christ Jesus. Both the head and the body are seated there next to God in the place of power and authority. That means we are seated there. We are seated in the power position and we are his heir. That means that everything that's his, including his authority, now belongs to us. We should remember that in Luke chapter 10 verse 19, Jesus said, he gave this authority to us. He got it from God the Father. Right now, Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father, and we are seated there with him. So we are seated with Christ in a place of spiritual authority, and we are to rule and reign in this life. How to use this authority? To use our authority in Christ hinges on the Ephesians chapter 1 verse 20 and chapter 2 verse 6, the verses that say we are seated with God in Christ. When adversity arises, we use our authority by speaking out what his word says using the name of Jesus. For example, we could say, sickness, I command you to leave my body in Jesus' name. According to 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 24, by his stripes I am healed. The authority is in the name. When we use the name of Jesus, believing that we are seated with him at the right hand of God, we are backed by all the power in heaven. Every knee must bow to that name. Jesus made it very clear that his name is the key to all authority. In John chapter 13, verse 13 to 14, Jesus says, whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. In Mark chapter 6, 12 and 13, the Bible says of the 12 disciples of Jesus, so they went out and preached that people should repent, and they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and healed them. In Acts chapter 3, when Peter and John encountered a lame man at the gate, beautiful, they said, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. And he did. It was not their own anointing or power that raised the man. It was the authority in the name of Jesus. That same authority belongs to us. Using the name of Jesus is how we use it. For this authority to work in our life, we must believe it. We must believe that God has said in his word about us. Believing or faith comes by the word. James 4:7 says, we are to resist the devil and he will flee from us. Instead of crying, the devil's after me, or rolling over when we are attacked, resist him. Push back with our faith, using our authority in Jesus' name. Jesus himself said in Mark 16 verse 17 to 18, and these signs will follow those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. The name of Jesus is full of power. Peter said in Acts 3:16 that the lame at the beautiful gate was healed through the faith in the name of Jesus. Matthew chapter 18 verse 18 says that whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven. We do the binding, heaven will refuse to allow what we allow. Satan, I bind you of my body, my family, my finances, my nation. I lose the power of God in those situations in Jesus' name. Every time we call on that name, God in heaven sees us through the eyes of Jesus. We can use his name in getting anything that we want. Jesus gave every believer in his name on earth the authority to use that name. Everything that Jesus wants to get done on earth today, he does it through the believers in his name, who has been given the power of attorney to act on his behalf. The transfer of this type of authority in our world today is what is recognized in the legal terms as the power of attorney. A power of attorney is the authority that is given to another person so as to act on behalf of the issuer in legal or any other matters. The power of attorney that Jesus gave to us as Christians more than 2000 years ago is still binding and effective in our world today. That means Jesus literally gave us the license to heal the sick, rescue those who are suffering, and do the works of God on earth today. The enemy knows this, but he goes about lying to people about it. His plan is to prevent them from exercising the authority that they do have over him. Jesus gave us the power to use his name on earth in the same manner. We are acting as his representative on earth today. Everything that Jesus wants to get done on earth today, he does it through the believers in his name, who has been given the power of attorney to act on his behalf. The name of Jesus is our unlimited spiritual supply source. We can use his name to get anything from our Heavenly Father at any time. This means that there is no limit to what God can do for us and through us. This power or authority comes with some conditions. This power is always to promote and glorify Jesus' name, never for personal glory. This power is not power or authority over other people. Both power and authority belong to Jesus, and he gives both to those who believe in him. So let us arise and function in the power and authority we have in Jesus as children, God's children. The enemy must no longer do as he pleases in any area of our lives. We are people of power and authority. We should demolish every incursion of the enemy into any area of our lives. Let us break every chain the enemy has placed around us. We have the power and authority to do so. May God use us for his service and glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for operating the eyes of our understanding to the authority that we have as your children. Let your church continue to heal the sick, support and announce the good news of your love. Help us to walk in that power and authority at all times through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let's we proclaim our faith by pronouncing Apostle Creed together. I believe in God,
the
Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in His Christ, the Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit
and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints,
the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
Let's we pray. In our intercessory prayer, we remember all our believers who are suffering from this COVID-19. We continue to pray for the whole world suffering from COVID-19. We continue prayer. We pray for especially those who are sick or dying, and especially for those who are poor and hungry. In our intercession, let us join our prayer for the whole family of mankind with the unceasing prayer of Christ the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we pray for justice and peace in the whole world and for fullness of life for everyone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who live in this Ranchi city, for the removal of all the devices from each other, and for true harmony in our country, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all engaged in agriculture, industry and commerce, for all workers, skilled and unskilled, and for all those who defend our country, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For teachers and students, scientists, artists, writers, and for all who influence the minds and hearts of others, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering, the poor and hungry, the destitute and oppressed, the unemployed, the sick and the dying, let us especially pray for those who are sick, especially who are infected by the coronavirus. Let us pray for their healing touch, God's healing touch upon them, that they may recover and they may come to praise God. Let us pray for all the doctors and nurses who are engaged in looking after them, and for all who help them, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our.
For all to whom authority is entrusted in this and other countries, and especially for our president, the prime minister, the governor, the chief minister of this state, and for all who have power over other people, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the unity of all Christian people and for their witness and service in the world, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For your whole church in our country, for its councils and leaders, especially for PCC, our moderator, Dharmaraj Rasnam, moderator of the Church of South India, and Mark Theodosius, Metropolitan of the Mark Soman Church, for blessing our bishop and for all other ministers of your church, that they may be faithful in their ministry. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That with all your people who have faithfully served you in this life, we also may share in the eternal joy of your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hasten, Heavenly Father, the coming of your kingdom, and grant us gracious
with your holy name of your Son,
our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The confession of sin. Beloved, our Lord Jesus Christ said, The Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your might, with all your strength. This is the first commandment. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us therefore confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved by God's grace to keep his commandments, to live in love and peace with all people. Let us pray together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have seen the gifts you have given us, in thought and word and deed, in the evil we have done, the good we have not done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our unbelievable fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of our Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant us to serve you in the newness of life, for the glory of our name. Amen.
Almighty God, forgive all, forgive one another, and truly repent of their sin, have mercy on you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
We are the body of Christ, and one spirit we are all baptized into one body. Let us pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So rise up and greet each other. Sing a prophetic hymn, hymn number 152. Stand up for Jesus. He should be on the cross.
Stand in the strength of the Lord.
arms of flesh will fail you. Peter, not just your own. Put on the gospel armor, each peaceful dawn with prayer. When you depart our danger, be never wanting death. Stand up.
And with them ourselves for service of the Divine Majesty. All things come from you and of
your own will redeem you.
Almighty God, Creator of the world, we ask you to rest with this offering, with the prayer of mind, the glory of your name, and the good of your people, which is Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord is here.
The Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
We like to give him thanks and praise.
It is not only right, it is our duty of joy, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty God, God always and everywhere to offer you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. He is your true and living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you alight and every world comes into the world, and from age to age you have raised up prophet and wise men to point the way to you. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to born us man to die upon the cross and to rise again for us. Through him you give your holy and life-giving spirit to make us your children and possible of new creation.
Holy God, our praises to the heaven and the songs of saints and angels before your throne. We commend the glory of your name and say,
he took bread, and after giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciple, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And the same way after supper, he took the cup, and having given you thanks, he gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. For so this is my blood of the covenant, which is set for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as long as you drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, through the grace of him, we set apart this bread and this cup. We celebrate and proclaim this perfect sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, this resurrection from the dead, and his ascension into heaven. And we look for his coming in glory. Please be seated. Pray together. Accept through him all the entire grace, this of sacrifice of thanks and praise, and then we can drink his holy gifts in the presence of the divine majesty. Renew us by your spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. With him and in him, through him by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and in heaven. We worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise.
His light is in us and we live in
him. As our Savior Christ has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and
forgive us our sins,
as our Lord will do
his sin against us.
Do not make me ask for my time, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory be yours, now and forever. Amen. We pray together on by Jesus Christ. We do not presume to come to this table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our righteousness, but in your name for the great mercies. We are proud of our gifts so much of the presence comes under your table. But you are the same Lord, whose nature is always fair and mercy.
Grant us, therefore,
gracious God, to believe in the grace of your Jesus Christ,
and drink his blood,
and also to warn you for those who we pray by his most precious body and blood,
and that we may come on dwell in him and he in us.
Yes. Amen.
This is the body of Jesus given for you. This is the blood of Jesus Christ shed for you. This is the body of Jesus Christ given for you. This is the blood of Jesus Christ shed for you.
Jesus says, "Go make disciples of all nations. Lo, I am with you always to the close of the age." Having now in faith received this holy sacrament, let us give thanks to God. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, we offer ourselves to the willing sacrifice.
Send us out from
the power of your Spirit to live and work
in your praises, O Lord.
Amen.
The peace of God and Father's all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in all the love of God and this Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The following members are celebrating their birthday this week. On 27 June, Ms. Arpana Nidhi Masi. 28th, Mr. Anshul Dadel and Mr. Rohan Barla. On 29th, Mrs. M. Kenswar, Mr. Pritish Simon. On 1st July, Ms. Sanon Khalko. On 4th July, Mr. John Chandan Walker. God has blessed them and we give thanks to God for His blessings showered upon them by saying Psalm 121. Psalm 195, 1-7. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into His presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to Him with songs of praise. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In His hand are the depths of earth. The heights of the mountains are His also. The sea is His, for He made it, and the dry land which His hands have formed. O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for He is our God, and we are the people of His pasture, and the sheep of His hand. O that today you would listen to His voice. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we offer you thanks and praise to you for the gift of life. We rejoice that you have given them beautiful life, the gift of life and love. Thank you for the giving them another year of life. Today they remember that you are their creator, sustainer and protector. In you they live and move and have their being. We thank you for your faithfulness and care through the years. Bless them with your presence and surround them with your love, that they may enjoy many happy years, all of them pleasing to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us give thanks to God for for the gift of child to Mr. Rohit Halko and Mrs. Jolly DeCruz. God, our Heavenly Father, has entrusted to Mr. Rohit Halko and Mrs. Jolly DeCruz with a beautiful daughter, Tasu. We give thanks to God for His blessings, the gift of child, by saying Psalm 128. Happy is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in His ways. You shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be happy and it shall go well with you. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots around your table. Thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, Creator of all things and source of all life, we praise you, praise your glorious name that you have blessed these your servants, Rohit and Jolly, the gift of a child, Tasu, and have filled their hearts with joy and goodness. We thank you for also for the health of mother. Accept our gratitude and thanksgiving through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
May I request to our secretary of English service, please come forward and make announcements.
A very happy and a blessed good morning to you all in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. On behalf of the English Service Committee, we would first of all like to thank our clergy for leading us on this online church service. Thank you, Reverend, so much. We would also like to thank all those members of our congregation, guests and choir and online shooting members for joining us on this online church service. We would like to thank Reverend Bimal Barla for his inspiring message on today's theme. The authority of Christ's messengers is based on their living contact with Him. Thank you, Reverend, once again. Notice for the week is as such, the church office timing is as such. In the morning, it will be open from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. and from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. it will be closed and again reopen from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. Please pray that we don't have a third wave of the COVID pandemic. For this, we have to follow the government guidelines strictly. Only when it is necessary, please come out of the homes, wear your mask, and time to time sanitize yourself. Please pray for yourself, your family, your neighbors, our doctors and nurses, and for us too. Thank you and God bless you.
Let's sing glory hymn, hymn number 204. Amazing Grace, how sweet the song.
That's it.
Pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for your holy and gracious presence. Thank you, Lord, the body and blood of your Son Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, you reminded us that we are your son and daughters. As a church, we have authority to heal sick and to save dying people. Help us that we may able to raise voice for oppressed people. Send us out that we may set an example for others and set a witness. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.